Close to 600 families were evacuated in the province of Pangasinan due to the storm surge affecting coastal villages. Terry Aquino on the line now with an update. Terry, over to you.
The province of Pangasinan has not been spared from the wrath of Typhoon Christine. Overnight, the typhoon pounded the province with its strong winds and heavy downpour along Lingayen Gulf, particularly the towns of the coastal towns of Agno, Anda, Alamino City, Bani, Binmalay, Bulinaw, Dagupan City, Labrador, Lingayen, San Fabian, and Sual. Early Tuesday, the Provincial Risk Reduction and Management Office had laid down plans and preparations to the possible towns where Typhoon Christine will traverse. All rescue assets of the PDRRMO were all pre-positioned to coastal towns for possible rescue operations. A total of 531 families or 1,801 individuals were rescued last night until early morning today and are now temporarily staying at the evacuation centers. This includes 88 families from 5 coastal barangay of Alamino City. Due to storm surge and high tide reaching up to 3.8 feet high in the towns of Sual, San Fabian, and Binmalay, rescued families chose to stay at a safer ground. Downtown Dagupan is still underwater because of high tide, where rain water cannot flow directly to the Pantal River going to the sea. But flood water is expected to subside at noontime today after the high tide. Gale warning has been up to 3.8 meters high, so fisher folks were advised not to go fishing until the weather condition improves. Power has been restored this morning in some towns of the 2nd District of Pangasinan after it was temporarily put off last night due to strong winds. Classes in all levels, private and public, were suspended by the province today, October 24, including works in the government but excluding those that are involved in disaster rescue and relief tasks. And those are the latest from our end here in Pangasinan.
All right, Terry, just a quick question for you. Is the worst over there in Pangasinan? And when are officials there expecting to herd all those evacuees back to their homes?
For now, Carmina, the weather is now improving. Right now, we do not experience rains compared the whole of last night, where on and off rains, heavy downpour is what has been experienced. Some of the evacuees are now beginning to going back home. Started around 9 o'clock in the morning. Yes, Carmina.
All right. Thanks a lot. Terry Aquino there joining us on the line. And back, number of homes damaged in Negros Oriental due to the bad weather. Meanwhile, Lapu-Lapu City in Cebu sends a team to flood-ravaged Bicol to help with the search and rescue operations there. Our very own Annie Perez on the line now with those stories. Annie?
Yes, Carmina, in Negros Oriental, 7 houses were severely damaged due to the effects of severe tropical storm Christine yesterday afternoon. These were homes located at Apo Island, a popular diving destination in the town of Dawin, Negros Oriental. 5 homes were destroyed by huge waves and strong winds, while the 2 others were hit by an uprooted tree. No one was reported hurt. In an interview with the Philippine news agency Dumaguete, Apo Island Barangay Chairperson Mario Pascobelio said that they observed high tide and they were also experiencing strong winds yesterday. Some 30 individuals of these homes were affected, and they already listed their names, assessed their damage, and as of the moment, they are working on giving relief aid to these affected individuals. Meanwhile, in Sitio Nalimbagan, Barangay Lumbangan, Mabinay, a farmer drowned at the Tabuay River. Based on the investigation of the Negros Oriental Police, the victim, together with his 2 companions, crossed the river. However, because of the strong current brought about by the severe tropical storm, the victim drowned and was carried away by the strong current. His companions successfully crossed the river. As we speak, search operations is also still ongoing to look for the victim. Search operations is also continuing in the area of Sitio Hakoton, Barangay Mamburao in the town of Pamplona, still in Negros Oriental, based on the Negros Oriental Police Provincial Office's report, the victims were aged 22 and 23 and they were fishing by the riverbank. Then a heavy rainfall occurred, which resulted in a flood, and the current was very strong and swept away both individuals. Only one was recovered and he survived the incident and is currently recuperating. And the officials and the disaster responders continue to search for the body today. Here in Cebu, the Lapu-Lapu City government held a send-off ceremony last night as they are sending a 10-man team based from the Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office to be sent to Bicol Region to help in the search and rescue operations after the onslaught of severe tropical storm Christine. They brought with them a lot of equipment, most of which are highly specialized for water rescue operations. And they're also sending in the best of their team. Along with them also are other supplies that will last the team and other pertinent objects for their operation. At present, there are already three individuals from the team who are now at Sorsogon who were initially part of the contingent of Lapu-Lapu City who joined the competition and was stranded. So the personnel of the disaster team stayed there to aid in the response. And Lapu-Lapu City Mayor Ahong Chan said that this is their commitment, said since these areas also in the Luzon region helped the city and Cebu, especially during Typhoon Odette in 2021. The Visayas Command is also utilizing their humanitarian assistance and disaster response, particularly in eastern Visayas, and they are aiding and helping individuals there for the preemptive evacuation and making sure that everything is in place to ensure the safety of the residents. So that's the latest here from Central Visayas. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot. Annie Perez there joining us on the line. Well,